Hello everybody, Video Lancer is on. In this video, I will show you how to create such a Zoom transition directly in Premiere Pro. Last time, we reviewed how to create the similar transition in After Effects. But as contrasted to After Effects, Premiere Pro is rather limited in tools for creation of any effects, so it is impossible to achieve the same level of quality. However, we will make the most similar transition out of the available effects. So let's start. Create a new adjustment layer and place it above the first clip. Shorten the adjustment layer so that its duration was no longer than a quarter of a second. Now we'll make zoom out animation. To do this, it is necessary to add mirrored image copies in order to fill these holes. It is easy to do in After Effects with the help of Motion Tile Effect, but unfortunately there is no similar effect in Premiere Pro, so we have to use more complicated workaround. Rename Adjustment Layer into Tile, and use Replicate Effect. Set Count Parameter on 3. Apply Mirror Effect. Place Reflection Center accurately on the junction of two tiles. Copy Mirror Effect and make Reflection for the opposite side. Repeat these actions for upper and lower tiles. Duplicate this adjustment layer to the third video track. Remove unnecessary effects and call it Scale In. Now apply Transform Effect. Set Scale Value on 300. This will return image size into its original scale. Due to tripling, the image has lost its original quality. But take into account that the transition will be quick and blurred, so quality change will be quite obscure. Set Animation Key for Scale on the first frame of the layer. Set Value 100 in the end of the layer. Let's add Motion Blur. To do this, switch off this checkbox and set Maximum Value for Shutter Angle. To do smoother animation, edit Keys Graphs. Now let's create animation for the second part of the transition. Duplicate the adjustment layer and call it Scale Out. Edit Keys Graphs in order to make ending of the transition smooth. Now let's add Chromatic Aberrations. Duplicate the adjustment layer on the fourth video track. Remove unnecessary effects and call it Aberrations. Extend the layer until it is a little longer than layers with scale animation. Apply VR Digital Glitch Effect to this layer. Set zero value for parameter distortion rate. Animate parameter color distortion so that the peak was at the junction. Make animation smoother with the help of graphs. Now we'll add optical distortions. Apply lens distortion effect. Animate parameter curvature so that the peak was at the junction. In order for animation to look better, Key's graphs for scale and curvature can be edited a little. It's ready. In the final, let's add a sound effect. It's ready. As effects of this transition are distributed on several layers, it's impossible to save it as a standard preset. However, you can create nest sequence for it that can be used in other projects. Now you can drag this transition from project panel into any sequence. Before doing this, you have to switch on the option of inserting sequence from other sequences. That is all. If you like similar effects, you can get thousands of similar transitions ready for use. All the transitions are professionally animated, and also, they include a sound effect. For convenience, every transition has preview and is applied by simple drag and drop method. If you want to get this package, please follow the link you can see on the screen. I do hope this video tutorial was useful for you. Subscribe to my channel not to miss new video tutorials. This was VideoLancer. See you later.